I don't think that that should be an issue. But on this issue of gender, we as a country must address it head on. Because we know the disadvantages that women face. Men will tell you, why do we want to nominate women? Why should we give women special positions? Why should they not just stand and be elected like men? It is not that easy. Number one, women are disadvantaged because women get married, they leave their position, places where they were born and brought up, and get married in other strange societies. She goes there, most of the times in another constituency. Now she goes there to run against a man who was born and brought up there. One, the discrimination. Oh, mwanamke ametoka mbali, si nataka mtu wa uko wetu. There, all the where she's going, the gentleman is running against has there his sisters, his brothers, his mothers, his uncles, who you to report na chunga na ngombe, who you to tahiri nae, na kadhalika. Her, the people who are close to her, she has left where she's come from. There she has also got brothers, she has got also mothers, she has also got cousins and so on. So if you were to run against her there as a man, she would beat you. Because of these disadvantages that women have, and also historical discriminations that have been exercised in our society from time immemorial. As a country, we must address this issue head on. Affirmative action is a must. That is the only way we are going to get a permanent solution to this issue. Then we are going to be able to unleash this potent force and energy for the faster development of our country. I know what the Abonyo family have gone through here, and you know I'm also related there because one of Abonyo's sisters, Dorothy, is married to my nephew. Is Dorothy in the crowd? There, there, there. That's married to my nephew. Kwa hivyo sasa, mimi nyawana. Nyawana hapa. But we, as a country, we must move on. Professor has told you about the story about cancer. When we were in the government, Mr. President, Professor Nyang Nyong'o, earlier on as Minister for Health, came up with a program to create a center of excellence, a center for research and management of diseases like cancer. And there was even land that had been identified for it. Because of ignorance, it was opposed by other members of cabinet, and they never saw the light of the day. So what Professor Nyang Nyong is talking about is something known very well. The details he has, he is able to share this information with your government. And if you follow that route, we'll be able to set up a proper facility that will help us to manage this cancer that is claiming so many of our people. As we are here, a former member of parliament for Kibra, Ken Okoth, has been cremated today, but a victim of cancer. And several others have been victims of late. Just these last 2 weeks, we have buried about 10 people who have died of cancer. So we must find a solution that will help us to manage cancer in our society. So, Your Excellency, I don't want to say so much. There, a member of parliament mentioned to you about the local problems they're having, the Moroni and Chemelil, and you go up to Miwani. There are solutions that we can discuss. so that these people cannot do not continue to suffer going forward. Yesterday, when we were in Bomet, we talked about Bosto Dam. Where we are, there's another dam here, Koru Soin Dam. The Koru Soin Dam is a project that has been pending here for a very long time. It will help the people of, in fact, three counties. Because where we are, there's Kericho, there's Nandi, and there's Kisumu this side. It's again a project that needs to be implemented with speed. And all these people are actually waiting for it. So, Your Excellency, we lay Lona to rest. Joyce. As a great lady, and as somebody has said, the professor will find something befitting here to name Dr. Joyce Laboso, whether a school, a hospital, or a street in Kisumu. Thank you very much. Maybe I can take this opportunity now to invite the Deputy President, Honorable Rev.